Okay, so we were here. Nings, Niksh, Nindamba. Dhatus are Nisi Chumbane. To kiss. Niksh Chumbane. Again, the same meaning. And Nidhi Kutsaya, which means to criticize. Niti. Yeah. After an Upendra, the na of the dhatus nisi, niksha, and nidhi optionally changes to na. So there is anuvritti of. It's the same thing here actually, which we read there. Upendrat anupadeshasya natvam. So like this is the main sutra. Here we can say that after an upendra, the original na of anupadesha dhatu is re-established. So here it's optional. So some say that the dhatus Nisi, Niksh, and Nidhi only undergo the change to Na when a Krit Pratyaya follows. Hinu is the combination of the Dhatu Higata Vriddhaucha and the Vikarana Shnu, one of the Vikaranas. Meena is the combination of the Dhatu Meen Hingsayam and the Vikarana Shna. So this is also, so like in Pushnati, so like that. An example of when Anip undergoes the change to Na. So this is talking of the previous sutra. Hino Meena Nipangcha. Prabhavani. This Anipava Pamap.
This na may not be in the beginning of the dhatu. It can be anywhere in the dhatu.
Yeah.
I see.
Prabhavani. So, pra yukta bhu yukta anip. So, the same way we made bhavani yesterday. And so, shakrishna dhatu ke dhaturantasya and the Shavatari Katmaki, and then Hinumina Nipangcha, that sutra.
Prabhu, even Rasha Radvayev, Rasha Radvayev, that also works here, right?
But what is the full sutra there?
Rasha Radvayev, Naha Sarveshra Hayava Kavarga Pavarga Vivadhane Api,
Samana Vishnu Pade. But they are different Vishnu Padas.
Okay, got it.
So that's why Upendra Anupadeshasya. So why do we say after an Upendra? I think this should be Upendrat. Upendrat iti kim. You know, in Sutra 408, Upendrat Anupadeshasya. So why Upendrat is said? So basically this is a vritti, combined vritti of previous 2-3 sutras. consider pra nayakaha, which means pragato nayakaha, a former leader. The Mahabhashya says dur upasargasya pratishedaha. The upasarga dur is prohibited from this Upendrat Anupadesha Sanatvam, I think, I believe. Thus we get Durbhavani. So Dur Upasargasya Pratisheda. So no Anatvam here. The author of.
What does it mean? Why do we say after an Upendra consider Pranayakaha? I did not get that. It's also Prah is also Upendra, right?
I think it will be explained here. Since in Pranayaka, there is no yoga with the dhatu. So Nayaka is not a dhatu. The word pra is not an upendra, but is just a simple avyaya here because Nayaka is a noun.
I see. So all these are avyayas, but if it comes in front of dhatu, it's upendra.
Upendra. Dhatu yoga techa prak. So like that. So the author of the Ashtaka Vritti says, Upasarga pratirupakatvad eva na natvam. Since dur only has the appearance of an upasarga, but is actually not an upasarga, it does not undergo the change to na, means the following letter. The statement dur upasargasya pratishedha means dur iti asya upasargatva nishedha. There is prohibition of dur being an upasarga. For instance, the Mahabhashya also says suduroho pratishedho num vidhitva ashatvanatveshu. The rule of num and the changes to shatva and natva don't apply in the case of su and dur. What is this num? I think the rule of num referred to here is upendrat labher num khal ghanavar and so on. Okay, this is one further sutra. Come ahead. Thus we get sulabham and durlabham. And sustutam and durneyam. So in this case, shatva and natva is not done. And this is that num doesn't come here. So we'll see the sutra ahead. And this is for shatva and natva, respectively. But it is understood that this statement has its exceptions. For example, dur yanam, so we do the natva, is formed by considering dur and upendra, and thus applying the change to natva by upendra, this and this. And yeah. Where the change to na would have been obligatory by Sutra 408, which is Upendra Nopadesha Natvam. Since these dhatus are Nopadeshas, beginning with Na Rama, this rule states that the change to na is optional. That's why there is a special rule here. In all the editions of Harinamamrita Vyakrana, the Sutra is listed as Nings Ningsh Nindam Va.
Is that the case in your tradition also?
Yes, yes. But one should know that Ninksh or Ninks therein is definitely a mistake. Means in mine, it is written like this.
Yeah, the second and word is Ninks. But here, Niks will take everyone, I guess. Niksha. Yeah.
Is it talking of the
second Niksha?
Means here, Matsyavatar Prabhu did not put a Rama, like after Sa or after Sha. Here we have a Rama even.
Yes, Prabhu, he is saying there is a mistake in other editions.
Oh, so it should be Niksha.
It's actually, he's saying, I think, Nims and Niksh, but he has added the Arama. I think if you read further.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so it says that in all the editions of Harinamamrita Vyakrana, this sutra is listed as Nings, Ningsh, Nindamba, including mine. But one should know that the Ninks therein is definitely a mistake because the dhatu Niksh, Chumbane, never takes Num. Mm-hmm. And because the equivalent Paninian sutra Va Nings Niksha Nindam lists Niksha, then there is mistake here, right? It should be Sha.
He's worried about the Ni, Na, Num in between.
No, comes. I'm just saying, I think there is typing mistake here. Because anyhow, in both.
He talks about that probably. The A he has added for this
sake no, of it. I'm not talking of arama. I'm talking of this cerebral sh.
Oh, I see. I see. Okay. Okay. Uh-huh.
Because that, even that in like both in both cases, it's the murdhanya sh, and here it's not. So I think this is typing mistake. But anyhow, so in this addition, we have also added aramas. Yeah, for the sake of pronunciation, as was done in the original Paninian Sutra, Va Nings Niksha Nindam, because the current sutra is obviously nothing but a rearrangement of the original Paninian Sutra.
Also, we are getting a modified version. Huh?
Okay, means I was going reading that file, you know, which you shared. What was the name?
The calf footprint, Panini in calf's half footprint, ocean of
Panini. Panini catching the ocean in a cow's hoof. So surprisingly, it read that, means it was really amazing. 1 minute, just. So on page 15, it says that Ashtadhyayi comprises of just 7,000 words. And if one undoes the sandhi and, you know, all the words which are joining, so if we split them apart, so we get 9,843 words then. But if you expand all the sutras and restore all the words elided through anuvritti, it would come across 40,000 words. Means it's like 1/6 compression. Oh my God. That is amazing.
Better than zip file, I guess.
Means just imagine, just by using one tool, which is known as anuvritti or adhikara, he has compressed his whole thing to 1/6 of what he is presenting. Oh, it's really good, actually. Compact. So this system of compacting things is current through traditions, actually. Amazing. So Angon Nena Vishnupadena Vyavidhane Natvam Na. But the change to Na does not take place when a Vishnupada other than Ang intervenes. So Pari Ava Bhu Anip. So again, Krishna Shab Krishna Dhatu Ke Dhatruntasya O Av Bhava and Bhavani. So we have an Upasarga here, which is Pari. This is a Dhatu. And we have a Vishnupada here, because Dhatu Yogate Cha Prak. If it comes before Dhatu, then we have to consider it as an Upasarga, Upendra, and a Vishnupada. We read that. So it's not Aang and it's Ava, which is a Vishnupada. So in this case, Idvamevaya Sarveshwari, Paryava Bhavani. So we do not apply the Natva here because of this rule. Aangon Nyena Vishnupadena Vithane Natvam Na. So no Natva here. This sutra and Sutra 36, which is 36, prove that when there is yoga of an Upendra and a Dhatu, the Upendra is considered a separate Vishnupada. Which is 36, Prabhu? Do you remember?
It's in the...
See, this is 46 is the Shavatara.
Upendra vachit Vishnupada adaucha.
Upendra, oh, 1 minute. Upendra, Upendra, I think this is in Sangya Prakrana.
Yeah.
What does the translation say?
I do not have translation handy.
Okay. Let us find that out. it's Sangya Prakarna. So
sometimes when ya is after an Upendra, even though it is at the beginning of a Vishnupada, its mode of articulation, this is articulation, Prabhu, is also Ishat Sparshitara.
Oh, it's talking of the pronunciation, articulation. Right. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Anyhow, then. So this sutra and that sutra prove that when there is yoga of an Upendra and a Dhatu, the Upendra is considered a separate Vishnupada. Thus, the Sandhi rules that take place when the Visha is Vishnupadanta are applicable there. In the example, Pariyava Bhavani, the Upendra Ava is intervening between the Upasarga Pari, which contains the prang nimitta ra, and then and the na of ani. Thus, the change to na by sutra 409 cannot take place. In the Krishnadasa edition, I think this Krishnadasa, actually this is my Guruji's name. Yeah, because when he was Brahmachari, so he was Krishnadas. I will tell my Guruji that he is famous. In the Krishnadas edition, the sutra is listed as Ango Nina Vishnu Padina Vyavadhani Natamna. So how it is? Oh, Vyavadhani. It's Saptami here. And here it's Tritiya, Vyavadhanina. However, in both these readings, the word Vyavadhanina is incorrect, since both Bala and Amrita says Vyavadhani Sati, indicating that the original correct word was Vyavadhani and not Vyavadhanina. So it's talking of that thing. Anyhow, that's like extension. Then Vakshyamana Kridadav Cha. When a Vishnupada other than Ang intervenes, the change to Na also does not take place in the Krit Pratyas and so on, which will be described later. For example, Pari A Bhu Yukt Anip.
So we can then, that means there are some places for Vishnupadanta, there are optionalities, right? So we can apply those also.
So when a Vishnupada other than Ang intervenes, the change to Na also does not take place in the Krit Pratyas and so on, which will be described later. But the change to Na certainly takes place when the Upendra Ang intervenes. So when we have Ang, so Shav Krishna Dhatu Ke and so on, Dhaturantasya, O Av, Bhavani, Parya Bhavani and Parya Bhavani. So here it takes place because it says Ang is an Angon Nena, it says Angon Nena. So this is carried forward, Angon Nena. Prapa Yanam. Where is Prapa Yanam?
In the Vritti?
Oh yeah, Prapa Yanam here. Yeah. So Prapa Yanam is an example of when Krit Pratyas follow. So it's formed by applying the Krit Pratyaya Ana after Pra Apa Yukta Ya in Bhave Prayoga. At that time, the current sutra blocks the change to Na, the Na of Ana, which would usually be achieved by Upendrad and this sutra, a further sutra. By the word Adi in Kridadav, the change to Na also does not take place in a Samasa when a Vishnupada other than arm intervenes.
Hmm.
For example, the change to na does not take place in hari, yaga, yogena, because the Vishnupada yaga is intervening.
So, just a question. This krit pratyaya, when there also we have the bhave prayoga and all, for example, hasate is bhave in bhave prayoga, right? Mm-hmm. If I say hasitaha, is that also bhave prayoga? I cannot use. I can still use the saha hasitaha, right?
Mm-hmm.
Maya hasitaha is not correct also.
Just a minute. So, karaka kridanta. So, the kridanta pratyas, they also carry this bhave prayoga, kartari prayoga, or karmani prayoga. So, if you check kridanta prakarana, the sutras, so it's just in front of me, like the initial ones. So, one sutra reads, to bhute bhava karmano, the pratyakta, you know, ta, like in bhakta and so on.
Yes.
It is used in past tense and is used both in bhava and karma, karmani prayoga.
So hasitaha is a bhava, is a kuta pratyaya, right?
Yes, hasita.
But saha hasitaha, maya hasitaha, you cannot write, right?
Saha hasitaha.
Hmm.
Maya hasita.
If I have to write in bhave prayoga with the word.
No, in karmani prayoga we can write maya hasita.
Maya hasite we can write. Maya hasita.
Okay, one thing is that hasita again is akarmak dhatu.
Yes, correct.
So we cannot bring it in hasita in karmani prayoga.
But bhave prayoga, for example, hasite.
Yeah, bhave prayoga we can do. Yeah, bhave prayoga.
Bhave prayoga and with the verb it makes sense, Prabhuji. Maya hasite, right?
Hasite.
Hmm. Hasate. I don't know. I'm just.
Okay.
Te. Te ate.
Yeah, that is a different thing. But in kridanta pratyas also we have the same things like.
But in kridanta pratyaya. It would be saha hasitaha, right? Even the kita pratyaya, it won't be like maya hasitaha.
Maya hasita does not match because has is not is a karmak dhatu, but saha hasita is right there.
So maya hasita, why I am saying is because bhave prayoga, you have to use it like that, right? Bhave prayoga, mm-hmm. when you are using, it should be maya hasite when you are using in the verb form. Because atmane pada pratyaya you use.
Yeah, that is different. You are bringing akhyata pratyas.
Correct.
We are talking of krit pratyas now.
Now with the krit pratyaya, you are
means we'll study them when they will come. So
because it looks equivalent to, you know, saha hasitaha, it looks equivalent to saha hasati, it looks equivalent to that, which is not in bhava prayoga, right? Which is a karmani prayoga.
Saha hasati is okay, let's do some research here. Hasita, smiling. So, Hasita is smiling here. Then, Hasita, smiling. So all these are Hasita, like with Kridanta Pratyas, Hasita, smiling. Same meaning actually.
But how do you use that in with like has dhatu is there, right?
Dhatu is has.
But how would it, the verb form will come?
Verb.
Hmm.
Yeah, just find out which category gana is it in. Has. So this is, I think, bhuadi again. Hasati.
Then it would become asate in Atmanepada, right?
Yeah, it says here. Te. Hasate.
So that's what my question was. Like, hasate, when you're using, you have to use maya in front of that, by me. Whereas hasati in Karmani Prayoga, you're using.
Yeah. That is right.
Yeah. But is that the same thing also in Karmani Prayoga and Bhave Prayoga in Kridanta?
Yeah, actually.
Maya hasita hasat hasita doesn't sound right, right? Saha hasita.
See, okay. Actually, it doesn't sound right, but it is right. For example, let me just give one example. Maya. Okay, let's put Krishna. Maya Pujitaha. Does it sound good?
Yes, Prabhuji. Here it is the object is object.
Yeah, because Pujitaha is Sakarmak, so we can put Akarma, an object. But,
yes, correct. But Akarma Dhatu can you use on?
Yeah, Maya Hasita. The act of smiling has been done by me. Maya Hasita. I cannot put Aham Hasita. No. It is wrong.
Aham Hasita is right, right? Saha Hasita.
No.
Krishnaha Hasitaha.
No, actually Aham Hasita is not right. Then it would be Kartari Prayoga, but Ta Pratyaya is not used in Kartari Prayoga. It is either used in Karmani or Bhave.
How about Krishna Hasitaha? That is again in Kartari Prayoga, right?
I have seen usages like that. For example, like I have seen like Evam Uktam Hrishikesham, right?
Yeah.
What is that? Evam Ukto Hrishikesham.
Udakeshenam Bharatam.
Evam Ukto Hrishikesham. So here we have Hrishikesham 1-1 and Ukta 1-1.
Right.
So this way it is right. Because this is also Kritanta Pratyaya, the same Pratyaya, Ta.
Hmm.
But Rishikesha was said by Gudakesha.
Gudakeshena, that's what you are saying.
Yeah. Gudakesha. So Rishikesha was thus, so it would translate as Rishikesha, literally Krishna, was thus said to, shall I put to here?
Hmm.
By Arjuna, literally. So although it looks like the same vibhakti, and it is also the same vibhakti, 1-1. But still, you see, two.
But again, here it is a sakarmaka dhatu, right? Uktaha.
Yeah, it is sakarmaka dhatu.
Is there any example with akarmaka dhatu?
Akarmaka dhatu.
Because sakarmaka dhatu, even I also have example like pataha patitaha, maya pataha patitaha.
Maya hasita is good. Aham hasita.
Saha hasitaha. Aham looks a little bit weird to me also. But
saha hasita is okay. So here hasita would act as a visheshana also. One who is smiling.
Right.
Saha hasita.
So in that case, this looks like karmani, isn't it?
Actually, how can we fit hasita in karmani? Because this dhatu is akarmak.
Then what is this one called?
I'm doubtful about saha hasita, this combination. I will have to check this akarmaka dhatu here. Sakarmaka is okay, but I'm really doubtful of akarmaka dhatu in such usages. So I will check this.
Sure, probably.
Because they are akarmaka, how can we bring them in karmani prayoga? Maya hasita is in bhavi prayoga. That is absolutely right. The act of laughing or smiling is being done by me. That is like bhavi prayoga. So that is right. But if we can put akarmaka dhatu in such way, like saha hasita or aham hasita, that is a question, and I will check that thing.
Okay.
But it was a nice discussion. So, yeah. Then.
I mean, there is one example I see that though. Bhagavad Gita 2.6. Te avastitaha.
Te?
Avastitaha.
Tell the full thing.
Te avastitaha pramukhe dhartarashtraha. Pramukhe.
No, tell the shloka. Can you please say the shloka?
Yes, Prabhuji. That's a big shloka. Do you want to open? It's na chaitad vidma kataran na gargi gariyo yatva jayem vad yadi va
no jay.
You remember. Okay. Yaneva hatvana jiji vishama mas te avastita pramuke dhartarashtraha.
Avastita is a karmak dhatu, satta. Satta, it is satta arthak, satta vriddhi vishuddhi siddhi shayane, ityadi. So akarmaka, te avastitaha pramukhe. So pramukhe in front, te dhartarashtra avastita. This would be the anvaya. In this case, avastita becomes the visheshana, adjective, for dhartarashtra, right?
Oh, okay. So this is a te, is in, I think this is with connected to te, isn't it?
Yeah, sahata ute, 1.3.
Is it 1.3 or is it tubhyam tavayoste mahyam mamayorme?
No. This is because this is 1.3, dhartarashtra 1.3. Then how would you put, where else would you put it? Tubhyam or tava?
Tubhyam. Tubhyam does not make sense. Okay. Yeah. Unto does not make sense. Yeah. Right. So then it should be 1.3. 1.3.
No, actually it can have the sense of tava pramukhe dhartarashtra avastita, because Krishna is speaking to, no, I think this is not Krishna speaking. This is Arjuna speaking.
So Prabhupada gives word for word, te as all of them.
I'm just talking on other hand.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Uh-huh. That Arjuna is speaking to Krishna, right?
This one.
So, right. I think Arjuna is speaking to Krishna.
Yes, yes, correct. And
yeah, so right. Arjuna might say to Krishna that if we consider tava, te as tava.
Hmm.
So, the Dhritarashtra, the sons of Dhritarashtra, are stationed, are situated. The sons of in front of you.
Tava pramukhe avastita, that's what you're saying.
Yeah, tava pramukhe Dhritarashtra avastita. That's our version.
That's nice.
But it sounds good, isn't it? But the acharyas, they take te as 1-3. Satavte. Te sarve. Te. So we'll take te as that. So here avastita is stands as visheshna of Dhritarashtra. And
why you are saying Dhritarashtra? I thought Dhritarashtra is a sambha.
Is
te Dhritarashtra is also te, right?
Te is 1-3, avastita is 1-3, yeah, yeah. Dhritarashtra is 1-3.
Yes, yes, yes. This is what
they are all. Yeah, they are all together. Te, Dhritarashtra, avastita.
I thought Dhritarashtra is sambodhana. It doesn't make sense.
No, okay. Means how will Arjuna address Krishna as Dhritarashtra?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. No, I didn't see the context. I was just looking at
it. Okay. So, yeah.
So then in this case, it is looking like a Karmani Prayoga, isn't it?
So you want to bring Karmani Prayoga? Basically, that is the idea. Okay, what is the karma then? Which Karmani Prayoga has to have a karma then. So that what would
Kartari Prayoga? That's what I want to say. Kartari Prayoga.
Yeah, this is Kartari Prayoga. And
Kuta in Kartari Prayoga.
Hmm?
Kuta in Kartari Prayoga.
Hmm. So we'll read the intricacies of these pratyas in Kridantas, because what happens is the general meanings are there. Like ta is generally used in past tense, it's generally used in bhava and karmani. But you know, in grammar we have a lot of exceptions. So when we read the whole thing, then it makes complete sense.
Yeah, sure, probably. Okay.
Then okay, we did Tukta Mantu, right? The parapada of Vidhata, Vidhatri. And this is the Atmapada of Vidhata.
Atmapada is starting here. Oh, a lot of things to catch up.
Okay, we'll stop here. So please revise, because 180 pratyas, then new sutras. So yeah, revise. And read one shloka. We were discussing shloka, I think. We did this 32 and it will be 33 today. Yatre me sadasad rupe pratishiddhe swasam vidha. Avidyayatmani krite iti tad brahma darshanam. यत्र यदा अविद्यया अज्ञानेन आत्मनि परमात्मनि कृते कल्पिते इमे सदसद रूपे स्थूल सूक्ष्म रूपे स्वसंविदा स्वरूप स्वरूप सम्यक् ज्ञानेन इति पूर्वोक्त प्रकारेण प्रतिषिद्ध निवारिते भवतः तत्तदा जीव दर्शन ज्ञानैक स्वरूपं ब्रह्म अचिन मुक्तं ब्रह्मभूतं भवति। सो व्हेन through the agency or through the medium of ajnan, ignorance, we impose kalpite, the sthul and sukshma rupa in Paramatma, which is pratishiddha nivarita, which is nivarita would be, which is prevented or kept far, removed by swasangvida, by samyak jnana, by proper knowledge. Tat tada jiva, then at that point, jiva, the living entity, jnaneka swarupam achin muktam. What is achin muktam? Chit, achit. Achin muktam.
Achin muktam. Yes, missing or something from word letter.
I think some mistake here because it should be chit, chit, not achit. Isn't it? How can we say achit? So, jiva, he becomes jnanaika swarupam, the. But first of all, he becomes Brahmabhuta, who is mukta. Who is Chinmaya? This shouldn't be there as per the context. And he becomes Jnanaika Swarupam. Literally, it would mean full of knowledge. Mm-hmm. Yeah, Jnanaika Swarupam, full of knowledge. And he becomes Mukta, he becomes Chinmaya. So yeah, this is it. Then what is the translation say of 1333? When a person experiences by self-realization, swasamvida is translated as self-realization, that both the gross and subtle bodies have nothing to do with the pure self. Here, pure self is taken, there Paramatma is taken. At that time, he sees himself as well as the Lord.
How come himself?
Atmani krite. Now here Atmani is taken as Paramatmani.
So Brahma Prabhupada is taking as Supreme Lord.
Oh, what is this? I think there is some Brahma Darshanam. Oh, actually what happened here is, here Prabhupada took Brahma Darshanam as one compound. The process of seeing the absolute, you know, Brahmanaha Darshanam. Here, Darshan and Brahma, they are taken as predicate or means for Jiva actually. They are taken in connection with Jiva. Like in the Anvaya, Jiva is brought, and then Jiva becomes Jnanaika Swarupam, he attains to Gyanika Swarupam, he attains to the platform of Brahma Bhuta, which is Chinmay and Mukta Avastha.
So here, Brahma Darshanam is, again, Brahmanaha Darshanam only, right? Otherwise, how else will take?
Brahmana Darshan is taken here, like by Prabhupada. Here, like when the jiva, who by ignorance was perceiving the sthul and sukshma sarupas in Paramatma, when such ignorance is removed by samyak jnana, proper knowledge, then he attains to Brahma Bhuta Avastha. Basically, he transcends himself beyond ignorance. And that is the stage where he is in complete knowledge. Yeah, complete knowledge, and he becomes freed. And yes, so that is Brahma Bhuta Avastha.
But so, still, if from the Sanskrit, just to that text itself, right? The, without the anuvada, not anuvada, the
anvaya.
So, darshanam, Brahma darshanam, how do you then, if it is not taken as a compound, what is the relationship between Brahma and darshanam? What is then darshan?
Means here we are following anvaya. So, anvaya is darshanam is jnanaika swarupam.
Darshanam is jnanaika swarupam. I thought it is a kind of the statement.
No, no. Darshanam is taken as jnanaika swarupam.
I thought darshanam after jnanaika swarupam.
No, no, no. Darshana is glossed as jnanaika swarupam. Means if it was, the anvaya wasn't like this, or I hadn't read the anvaya, then I would have taken also like Brahmana Darshanam, which Prabhupada took, because it becomes easy in that sense, Brahmana Darshanam.
So how darshana is in Jnanayaka Swarupam translated, Prabhu?
Means, I think we should check Sridhar Swami, what he does with that. This is 1333, we can check. So see, Sridhar Swami says darshanam jnanaika swarupam. Haripur?
Yes, Prabhuji, I am seeing that. Katam bhutam has become a...
So, jivasya brahmatam aha. The Brahma Bhut Avastha of Jiva is being told in this shloka. So, ime sthul sukshma rupe swasamvida shravana mananadi bhaktya swarupa samanyanena pratishiddhe bhavatah jnanena pratishedha arhatve tameva hetumah avidyaya atmanikrite kalpite iti hetoh tad brahma tada jiva brahma bhavati iti artha kadam darshanam jnanika swarupam. So he's not bringing in Paramatma here. Sridhar Swami is taking from jiva's point of view. But Bhaktisiddhanta Prabhupada, he takes the Paramatma angle also.
Okay.
Yeah.
Darshan, I was just thinking, it's a seeing, act of seeing, right? This looks like another meaning.
Just
Drishyam.
What was that? Jnanaika Swarupam. So Drish has got a lot of meanings. To see, behold, look at, regard, consider, understand. So understand is very close to gyan, understanding.
Oh, I
Not
see.
is careful, look into like even like darshana shastra. You know, darshan is very close to philosophy in that, in one sense.
Yeah, there, this if you read the Satyanarayan Babaji, he's Tattva Sandarbha, he says darshanam means the act of seeing. That's why they are all the six sad darshanas. They actually want to see the ultimate goal, the act of experience. That's how he translates.
So, yeah, darshana. Darshana. To see by divine intuition also. Quite amazing. Think or find out, compose, control. So, yes, it makes sense. Jnana ke swarupam, darshana. Okay, so we'll stop here for today and we'll continue on tomorrow. Yeah. Tomorrow is Friday actually. Yeah, Sridhar. What we'll do. What is that, Prabhu?
Sridhar Swami's commentary tomorrow.
Yeah.
So just one question, pronunciation question. This Ubhayapadi, Ubhayapadi Bhyam, Ubhayapadi Itascha, how do you pronounce that?
Just a minute. Ubhaya padibhya ubhaya padani nitascha.
Nitascha, I thought the atma padibhya atma padani nitascha.
That is like ka kha ga gha ma ma nitascha nitascha. Like masi mas, like that.
Yeah, this one.
Ubhaya padibhya. So first of all, you fix your tongue with cha 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 nya. You know, to fix that nya.
Okay.
Then cha cha ja jha nya. Then ubhaya padibhya ubhaya padani nitascha. You know, just stick your tongue at that place.
Nya nitascha. Is that nasal is also called nitascha?
Yeah, it is nasal, of course, but the tongue should go in that direction of cha varga, the talavya, talu.
Oh, I see. Mm-hmm. Nitascha, nitascha, I see.
Ubhaya padibhya ubhaya padani nitascha nitascha.
That sounds like a na nitascha when you are saying.
No, means of course there is very subtle difference, but means what my concept is, formula is, the tongue should go there, which has been given. So if the tongue is going there, and then I consider it is okay. Otherwise, what is the basis of differentiating. So the place of articulation is the base of differentiating. So yeah, talu. Okay, bro.
Thank you, bro.
Okay, Hare Krishna, bro.
Hare Krishna.